transfer takes place, conduction heat transfer takes place between two contact surface solids. That is the porous law of heat conduction is Q is Q equal to minus Ka dT by dx. Minus sign indicate the heat transfer will decrease with increasing distance. That is minus K thermal conductivity of the materials. That is ability of material to conduct the heat. Okay. dT by dx is change in temperature and dx is distance. So thermal gradient. From this equation we can derive the thermal heat conduction equation, the basic equations. We can derive the general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. Cartesian coordinate x, y, z. Here one dimensional temperature fluidic system with temperature is function of x coordinate, y coordinate, z coordinate and t, time. So steady state means temperature will be constant. Steady state temperature will not vary with respect to time. So that is steady state conditions. So dou t by dou the differentiation of temperature with respect to time will be zero. And one dimensional means only have to consider heat flow only one direction, that is x direction. Generally we will consider in the x direction only. So dou square t by dou x square equal to some function of functions. Other dou square t by dou y square is equal to dou square t by dou z square equal to zero. And the heat internal heat source, heat generations. Heat source is placed inside the wall. That means the system is generated by the electrical source, heating coils, that is heat source. So generally heat conduction equation Cartesian coordinates dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q, internal heat generations q is equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou small t, alpha thermal diffusivity, dou t by dou small t is equal to, that is transient heat conduction. So steady state that term will be 0, dou t by dou small t is 0. No heat source, Q term will be, small Q term will be 0. In the PowerPoint, the voice will mark the pen. Q is equal to minus K A dT by dV, dT by dx, that is Fourier's law of heat conduction. All the equations in Cartesian coordinates derived based on these equations. The second equation is general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates, that x direction, y direction, z direction. This one is heat generations, and equal 1 by alpha, alpha is thermal divisivity, dou T by dou small t, at temperature varies with respect to time. So how to simplify this equation for plane 1? So plane 1, only one direction, heat flow in one direction. So other z direction, y direction, z direction will be 0. So no heat generations, no heat source and steady state. So other term will be 0 except dou square t by dou x square. conduction equation for plane bonds. How to the point heat flow through the plane bond? What are the boundary conditions? Plane bond, the length of the plane bond is L. What are the boundary conditions? Boundary conditions at x is equal to 0, temperature T equal to Ti, at x is equal to L, temperature T equal to T2. So you based on these boundary conditions, you can find out the heat flow through the plane bond. How to find temperature distribution through the plane bond? How to integrate the equations? D square T by D x square. So you can write d square d by dx by dx is equal to constant. Again you have integrated the equation, T equal to C1x plus C2. So now substitute the boundary condition, you can find the T in terms of temperature and the x coordinates. First of all, substitute the boundary condition at x equal to 0, T equal to T1. X equal to 0, P equal to T1. So 0 plus so T2 equal to T1. And X is equal to X is equal to L, T equal to T2. T2 equal to C1. Yes, C3 is equal to C1. So C1 equal to P2 minus P1 divided by N. Now substitute C1 and C2 values in P equations. We will get the temperature distribution through the thickness of the solid. Through the plane bond. So T is equal to C1 P2 minus P1 X by L plus C2 P1. This is temperature distribution through the plane bond. Using this equation, you can find out the temperature distribution at any point in the plane bond. This is general heat conduction is derived from the Cartesian coordinates. How the copper conduct the good conductors? How copper is a highest conductor, so more conductor compared to other materials. So what is the reason? So what is the reason? 3-4 months only I know that how conductor is the best, copper is the best conductor heat. Based on the atomic number of the copper is 29. Atomic structures, atomic number 20, copper is 29. Atomic number is this. First is using 2N equations. So N equal to first 1 means first N is 2. N equal to 2 means N equal to 1. So that is equal to 2 electrons. N equal to 2 means number of electrons is equal to 8. N equal to 3 means number of electrons is 3.
and 18. So 18 plus 8, 26 plus 2, 28 electrons. This is 18. So what the remaining electron is? Suppose 18 here. This is 18. So remaining electron is? Total number of atomic number is 29. First inner cell occupied 2 electrons. Next cell, next occupied 4. 8. Remaining is 18. Another remaining is 1. If 1 electrons, the one on the nuclear circuit, that is will be a good conductor. That is the reason. Insulating 4 means semiconductor, 5 to 8 means insulators. Silicon, what is the structure number of atomic number of silicon? Silicon is atomic number of the silicon. Atomic number of silicon is 14. What means best conductors? Outermost cell occupies the one cell occupies the outermost orbital, that means a good conductors. So copper example. Silicon atomic number is 14. Only outer orbital will have only 4 electrons, that is a semiconductors. If outer orbital 4 to 5 to 8 electrons occupy in the outer orbital, that means a insulators. Silicon. So first time we have 2 electrons. Second 8. So 8 plus 2, 2 plus 8, 10, remaining 4. That is semiconductors, silicons. The reason one electron means there will be good conductors. So conductions plays with in two mechanisms. First is molecular interactions and by drift of free electrons. The molecular interaction with the energy exchange takes place by the kinetic motion or direct impact of the molecules. Molecules are relatively higher energy level to energy to adjacent molecules at lower energy levels. Another one is by drift of free electrons. That is based on these electrons, free electrons. By drift of free electrons as in case of metallic alloys. The metal alloys have a different concentration of the free electrons and their ability to conductivity is directly proportional to concentration of the free electrons. That is, consider free electrons, copper is an example. That is proportional to free electrons. So conduction is between solids. Generally solids, conduction will take place in air medium also. But compared to solids, conduction in fluid medium will be negligible. So we are omitting the conduction in fluids. So we are then to next conduction. Conduction is
conduction heat transfer takes place means one medium is refined. Heat transfer takes place from solid to fluid mediums. The fluid may be either water or air. So conduction. So how do the equation, general equation, conduction Q is equal to HEI and temperature difference. H is heat transfer coefficient. Area, surface area, surface area. And temperature differences. TS minus T infinity. TS surface temperature of the hot body. T infinity atmospheric temperatures. Excuse me. So when your fluid flows inside your duct or flow over your solid body and the temperature of the solid and the surface temperature are different, the heat transfer between solid and the fluids will take place. This is to the motion of the fluid related to the surface. This type of heat transfer is called convection. There are two types of convection, free and forced convection. Free convection, we will not consider the external force. We will not consider external force. What is the external force? Velocities. That is blower or fan used to supply the air, some transfer particular velocities. So without velocity terms, that convection is called the free convection. If consider the velocity will, that type of convection is forced convection. Then we have to find out what is the aim of the convection. You have to find out the heat transfer coefficient. So basically for free convection, what are the non-temperatures are used? Kirchhoff number, beta g L cube, temperature delta T divided by kinematic viscosity mu square. So based on this, you have to find out the Kirchhoff number. The properties of air taken from the average temperature of the fluid and air temperatures. And Prandtl number, V Cp by K. So this, based on this number, you can find out the heat transfer coefficient. Then another non-dimensional number is numeric muscle number, Nu equal to HL by K. From this, HL by K is over. Then from this equation, you find out the muscle number is function of Kirchhoff number and Prandtl number. Then from this equation, you can find out the H. Then Q is equal to HA and then we have
T. Two different conditions.
Based on that is solid, flow over cylinder, flow through the cylinders, different conditions. Third one is radiations. Where conduction, convection will be observed. This is another mode of heat transfer. So electromagnetic wave can travel through the vacuums. Such a heat transfer is called radiation. That is, if two bodies at different temperature are placed in an adiabatic enclosure. They are enclosed so that they are not conducting through solid medium or fluid medium. The temperature of the two bodies tend to become equal. So the mode of heat transfer by which the equilibrium is actually is called thermal radiation. That is Q is equal to emissivity, area, surface temperature, area, temperature difference between the two bodies. T power 4. So next. So this is a general. Yes, temperature field and the temperature gradient. That means the general equation. T is function of x, y, z, t. X means x direction, heat flow in x direction, one dimensional, y direction, z direction, small t is time. Suppose steady state means what time will you have to eliminate? Steady state. Which time you have to eliminate? Time is constant. So which parameter? T parameter should be eliminated. Only you have to consider x, y, z directions. So one dimension means other terms. YZ will be 0. That is the next. So temperature is only function of space coordinate. Next, T equal to F2. If the temperature is a function of only two coordinates. Two coordinates means only of Z coordinate. The Z coordinate will be 0. Heat flow in Z direction will be 0.
for two dimensional field, and the temperature variation in the third coordinates is negligible. Similarly, if the temperature is a function of only one coordinate, so y z coordinate will be zero. So temperature is function of only x coordinate. If time is considered unsteady, means you have to consider t. So t is function of x comma t. Next, another equation is the equation is a one-dimensional steady state temperature field is T is equal to f of x only. Next is like so four general law, four is law of heat conductions. Q is equal to, Q is directly proportional to normal area, the flow to the normal A into dou T by dou x. So Q is equal to minus KA dou T by dou x. The K is equal to coefficient of thermal conductivity, which is the physical property of the substance. That is ability of the material to conduct the heat. So unit is watt per meter Kelvin. So this is a basic equation in conductions. All derivations derived from the Fourier's law of heat conduction. Next, the thermal conductor various substances at the standard temperatures varies with respect to temperature. Generally, thermal conductivity varies with respect to temperature at particular point or particular temperature, 20 degrees Celsius. The thermal conductor varies substance. Silver 402, 407, copper. We are not using silver because it will be cost of the cost. So next, copper we are using as a conductor of conductor materials. Copper 386. Next one, aluminium 175, mild steel 737, lead 49.8, stainless steel 19, wood 0.15, asbestos fiber 0.95, water 0.1, air 0.022 due to the very low thermal conductivity, less thermal conductivity of the materials. So we are conducting in air will be negligible compared to solids. So we are not studying conduction in air. So next, the general differential equation of heat conduction. So next, this is heat flow in x direction, y direction, and z directions. So space heat flow in these directions. First, heat entering the element. This is a small element. It has sides dx, dy, dz. Heat entering the element. Qx equal to minus Ka dT by dx. So the general consider small volume element in Cartesian coordinate having sides dx, dy, and dz, shown in the figure. So how the general heat conduction is derived? What is the value? From the first law of thermodynamics. Q is equal to application. Q is equal to work done plus change in internal energy. That is from the steady flow energy equations.
We can work out
steady flow energy equation, potential energy, rate of kinetic energy, enthalpy, plus heat transfer equal to potential energy at the living system, kinetic energy, plus work done, and other terms, that terms. So work done in solids will be negligible. Work done in solids will be negligible. So Q, W term will be zero. So Q is equal to general change in energy, delta U. Delta equal to M. Internal energy, mass, specific heat and temperature with respect to constant time. Generally equals net heat conducted in element dx, dy, dz per unit time equal to internal heat energy generated per unit time equal to increase in internal energy per unit time plus voltage by unit element per unit time. So that is Q, capital Q plus small q equal W plus delta U. So the capital W will be zero. Then capital Q plus small t equal to delta U. So now the rate of heat flow into the element x directions. The x direction Q sub is x equal to Kx, thermal conductivity in the x direction Kx. Area is dy dz, normal to x directions. So dy into dz. So dy dz into dou t by dou x. Then the rate of heat flow out into the element in x direction through the face at x plus dx, that leaving, that is equal to q suffix x plus dx equal to qx plus derivative of qx. But next, so that is equal to qx plus qx plus derivative of qx, that is equal to minus kx dou t by dou x into dy dz. So that term will be qx and the minus will be 0. So the final term is dou square, then dou by dou x into kx dou t by dou x into dx dy dz. So again you have to differentiate that equation. So dou square t by dou x square into k into dx dy dz. So each term will contain volume of the element. Each. So similarly, heat, that means so heat stored by the way. That energy that the energy stored in the element in y directions, same equations, qy minus qy plus dy is equal to partial derivative dou by dou x into k. Y direction means ky. So dou t by, so this is z direction, third one is z direction. So qz minus the heat energy stored in z direction. So entry and difference between entry and the exit leaving. So qz minus qz plus dx equal to partial derivative dou by dou z into kz into dou z by dou t by dou z into dx dy dz. So total is all terms, z direction, x direction, y directions. Next. So this is the general heat contacted with the elements dx dy dz per unit times. This is equation 1, that's part of the equation 2. Next, we find the internal energy, delta U. Internal energy, delta U is equal to mass, specific mass of the element, specific heat of the element, into temperature, change in temperature, within time, dou t by dou small t. Then mass equal to density. Mass equal to density, volume. So that is the area written, right? So delta U is equal to rho Cp dou t by dou small t into volume dx dy dz. Next one, internal heat generation small q. The internal heat generation, that is, let q be the internal heat generation per unit time and unit volumes. That is equal to q equal to dx dy dz. So this is the fourth equations. Now substitute all the equation in first common general equations. So we will get this equations. So next we find it divided by volume dx dy dz. Divided by that terms. So remaining term is this term, dou by dou x kx dou t by dou x plus dou y into ky dou t by dou y plus dou y, that is z direction. This is z. This is y direction. This is z. Dou by dou z kz dou t by dou z plus q equal to rho cp dou t by dou small t. Next. So assume kx are the homogeneous materials. Kx equal to ky equal to kz equal to k. the properties will be same at all points and directions of the homogeneous materials. So K is equal to, but divided by K, that is equal to dou square d by dou x square plus dou square d by dou y square plus dou square d by dou z square plus q by k. That is equal to rho by Cp by k into dou t by small dou small t. That term quantity, thermal conductivity divided by rho Cp is called thermal diffusivity. So general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinate is dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square d by dou z square plus q by k equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou small t. This is general heat conduction equation. Using this equation you can derive for plane one composite ones, because with the heat generation, without heat generation you can derive this equation. Next one. This is the various cases how to simplify the general heat conduction equations. What are the 10 terms? First is steady state, which dou t by dou small t will be 0. The temperature will be constant. T is function of only spatial coordinates. T will be constant. So derivation of derivative of time is will be 0. So dou t by dou small t will be 0. No heat source. Heat source Q term will be small q will be 0. Third is one dimensional heat conduction with a steady state, no heat source. One dimensional we have to consider only x direction. Steady state dou t by dou small t will be 0. So that is next case, two dimensional heat conduction with the steady state. Two-dimensional heat conduction with the steady state, no heat sources. So we have to consider only x and y directions. Third condition, three-dimensional heat conduction. So you have to consider only x and y, z coordinates, no heat sources. Another next condition, one-dimensional heat conduction equation with this unsteady state, no heat sources. So no heat source, Q term will be 0, so various conditions. So that is 10 different conditions. That is division, no heat source, Q term, P will be 0, means that equation is called division equations. Last one, Poisson equations. The term dou t by dou small t equal to 0 means that equation is called as Poisson equation. The two more questions they will ask, write the Poisson equation. Then, okay, next. This is one dimensional steady state heat conduction. That is, what is the heat transfer? What is the heat flow through a plane bond? We can derive by two methods. One is, you can derive the general heat conduction equation, or we can derive from Fourier's law of heat conduction. First method is, one considers plane one of uniform thermal conductivity K, within the, which is assumed to be extended to infinity in x direction, y directions. The temperature is a function of x direction only. The general heat conduction equation is dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q by small q by k equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou small t. That term except this one dimensional with one dimensional steady state heat conduction. So x heat flow in x direction and y direction will be 0. Steady state dou t by dou small t will be 0. So final term is dou square t by dou x square equal to 0. Now using boundary conditions, you have to find out the temperature, T equations. T is function of temperature. We can find out the temperature at any points in the plane one. So what are the boundary conditions? At x is equal to 0, starting point, temperature T equal to T1. at x and next quantity, another second quantization is that the x is equal to L. That means L means here start length, thickness, heat flow through the only thickness. So at x is equal to L, T equal to T2, total boundary conditions. So integrate that, first integrating the equation 1, T equal to C1x plus C2. C1, C2 are constant. Using boundary condition, we can eliminate the constant. So at T equal to T1, at x is equal to 0, T equal to T1, so the term C2 will be 0. Then x is equal to L, T equal to T2, we can get C1 equal to T1 minus T2 divided by L. Then the final, therefore, T is equal to T2 minus T1 into x divided by L plus T1. This is a general temperature distribution through the plane 1. You find the temperature of the plane 1 at the x is equal to 5 centimeter. So we can use these equations. Then how to find out the heat flow through the plane 1? What is the porous heat conduction equation? Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx. So you have to derive this equation with respect to x, then substitute this value in Fourier's law. So dou t by dou x is equal to T1, T2 minus T1 is divided by L is constant. Differentiation of x is 1. So differentiation of T1 is 0. This is double constant. So let's substitute the dt by dx in Fourier's law equation. So Q, Fourier's law of heat conduction equation is Q is equal to minus Ka dt by dx, that is equal to minus Ka d2 minus t1 into L. So that is equal to Q equal to t1 minus t2 divided by L by K. That is temperature difference. Q is equal to temperature difference divided by thermal resistance. That is L by Ka. This is a general heat conduction equation for one-dimensional steady state. This is obtained from general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. Second, next slide. So method 2 is derived from directly can apply direct from the Fourier's law directly. So Q is equal to minus Ka dou t by dou x, that is equal to Q dx equal to, again you have to return dx, you have to eliminate. So internet the equations. One second, I have written here dx, not constant dx. So what's the limit, x limits? X limit? 0 to L, x thickness, 0 to L. So integrate the dx, integration of dx is 0, then after limit is 0 to L. Temperatures varies from T1 to T2. So the Q into x2 minus x1 equal Ka d2 by T2 minus T1. Then Q is equal to Ka d2 by T2 minus T1 divided by x2 minus x1. That is equal to temperature difference. X2 minus x1 is L. Then L by Ka. So same equation we will get. This is what based on this derivation on numerical problems. Calculate the rate of heat loss for a red brick wall of length 5 meter and height 4 meter and thickness 0.25 meter. The temperature of the inner surface is 110 degree Celsius and that of outer surface temperature is 40 degree Celsius. The thermal conductivity of red brick, K equal to 0.770 watt per meter Kelvin. Calculate also the temperature at interior point of the wall 20 centimeter distance from the inner wall. but thickness is, what thickness is x2 minus x1, that is L equal to 0.25 meters. Thermal conductivity K equal to 0.7 watt per meter Kelvin. Inner temperature is 110, so that is equal to T1. Outer surface temperature is T2, 40 degrees Celsius. Areas length into height 5 to 4 20, so Q is equal to temperature difference divided by thermal resistance L by Ka. You can substitute in Kelvin, generally you can substitute in Kelvin only. So 383 minus 330 divided by L is thickness 5 to 5 divided by K 0.7, area 4 into 5 20, that is 3920 watt. Then again temperature temperature at the interior point, point of the wall 20 cm from the inner surface starting points. So x equal to 20 cm. If you know the temperature equation, T is function of temperature, T is function of x. Generally you can find out the temperature at point 20 cm from the starting point. So T equal to temperature difference divided by ratio x by L plus inner temperatures. So that is equal to T2, that is equal to 327 Kelvin at x equal to 20 cm. So this is based on the plate wall. Next, this is the opposite wall. So next, the view in our directions. Next, opposite one derivations. Front of opposite one is in the middle. Where for you? So the composite wall you have to consider two materials are different, two or three. How to derive the general heat condition equation for composite wall? Opposite plate wall. Okay.
transfer coefficient HA, HB, both sides given, given. So you have to consider what are the heat flow equations. First, in the left hand side, HA is given. So you have to consider convection. Then, in the then conduction, you have to consider conduction. Then again, you have to conduction with the different thermal conductivities. Again, you have to consider conduction. Last one is convection. So, how to derive these equations? Overall temperature, that means Q is equal to temperature difference. Temperature difference divided by thermal resistance. So, Q equal to delta T by resistance. But you have to consider thermal resistance, you have to consider convection and conductive resistance and protective resistance. Conductive resistance is 1 by convection, that means change in temperature divided by 1 by HA. Q is equal to delta T divided by, that is Q is equal to HA delta T, that is delta T 1 by HA. So this is conductive resistance. So if consider the conduction term, you have to consider conductive resistance. So conduction is delta T divided by L by K. So Q is equal to first this HA. Area per unit area 1 meter square. So then TA minus T1 that again equal to K A minus so T1 minus T2 K1 then K A minus here now one plus two minus so right or you can put so Q is equal to HA TA minus T1 equal to, then equal to, you have to consider conduction heat transfer. So K, K1A for first material, K1A, that is L1, the temperature T1 max T2, that is the next, that is equal to heat conduction in second part K2A, that is L2, with the T2 minus T3, then you have to consider third material, K3A, that is L3, T3 minus T4, then how to consider convection heat transfer. So TBEA T4 minus TB. Then again that term is equal to TA minus, that is overall temperature difference, TA minus TB, that is equal to TA minus T1. How to consider first convection level? Air to solid mediums. The temperature TA minus T1, temperature difference. Then plus T1 minus T2, now again, then plus T2 minus T3, then plus T3 minus T4, then T4 minus TB. So the term equal to TA minus TB. One side minus 1, other side plus 1, so it will be cancelled. Again plus T2, another side is minus T2, that will be cancelled. Final term will be TA minus TB. Now we substitute the heat flow equation, that means in terms of Q. What is the first term? TA minus T1. TA minus T1 is convection heat transfer. What is the convection heat transfer? TA minus T1. TA minus T1, that is equal to, what one is Q. So this term equal to Q by HCA suffix A to A. That is equal to QHAA. That is again this T1 minus T2 term. This is equal to QL1 by AA. Then again this is equal to Q. Plus can write Q is equal to 1 by HCl in this systems. 1 by 1 by 1 by 1.
On the equation you can write like this. So just you have to apply 1 by K1A, 1 by K2A, just 1 by K3A, plus 1 by H3.
The general heat conduction equation in composite wall. It is one of the method we can derive this equation.
That's the problem.
This is a numerical example.
The wall of 0.5 meter thickness is to be conducted from a material which has an average thermal conductivity of 1.4 watt per meter Kelvin. The wall is to be insulated. Wall is to be insulated with the material having an average thermal conductivity of 0.35 watt per meter Kelvin, so that the heat loss per square meters will not exceed 1450 watt, assuming that inner and outer surface temperature are 1200 degrees Celsius and 15 degrees Celsius respectively. Calculate the thickness of the insulation required. That is, L, we have to find out the thickness of the insulation materials. Insulation material. So L1 is thickness of the first wall is 0.5 meter. K1 thermal conductivity material. One is equal to 1.4 watt per meter Kelvin. Next, thermal conductivity for material 2, K2 is equal to 0.35 watt per meter Kelvin. So, heat loss of heat flow, Q is equal to 1450 watt. T1 equal to 1473 Kelvin and T2 equal to 380 Kelvin. So, that this composite wall, so using this equation, only no conductions. So that 1 by HCA term will be 0. This general heat conduction equation. So temperature is 2 temperature between inner and outer surface temperature. If this is no convection, so this term will be 0. Then you have to consider these 2 term only. L1 by K1A, L2 by K2A. Here area is heat loss per meter square. So A will be 1. So temperature difference Q by A equal to temperature difference divided by thermal conductive resistance L by K1 plus L2 divided by K2. So L1 is given, K1 is given, L2 is not given. How much heat insulation materials required for heat loss? So you have to find out the L2. When K2 is given, you substitute all the values, we can get L2 is equal to 0.16 meter. So this thickness of the insulation material is required to obtain heat loss 1450 watt. Next. It's not visible, eh? Diagram is not. So this is only complicated composite wall problem. 3, 4. You can move. Serious problem. Serious is considered like series connection, series connection and parallel connection. So how many materials total? 1, 2, 3, 4, total 5 different materials are there. 5 different materials. A is 4 materials. Material A, D and E are connected in series, actually like electrical resistance. B and C are connected in parallel connections. Well, there is no convection, So the term will be zero. First you have to find out the thermal resistance for five materials, five different materials. What is thermal resistance? L by KA. For material A, determine the heat transfer through the composite block shown in figure. Take the conductivities of A, comma B, comma C and D as 15, comma 10, comma 6.67, comma 20 and 30 watt per meter Kelvin respectively. Assume one dimensional heat transfer. So first consider, first find out the thermal resistance for A. So Ra equal to L by Ka. L is 5 cm. So 0.05 divided by Ka. Ka is 50. Area is 1. Is given into the area is 1. So that is equal to 0.001. Then thermal resistance for B equal to Lb divided by Kb into A. That value is length is 0.1 divided by 10 into 0.5. That is equal to A is 0.5 here. Previous one area is 1. For area for B is 1 because B and materials are combined together. So half of the area. So area for B B material is 0.5. B and C. That C to RC equal to LC divided by KC into area. So K equal to L is equal to 0.1. KC equal to 6.67 into area is half of the total areas. So 0.5. Then RD equal to LD divided by KDA. Here area is thermal resistance for material D is area is 1. So LD equal to 0.05 divided by 20 into 1. So that value is 0.0025. Then RE equal to LE divided by KDA. L is 0.05 divided by 30 into 1. So that value is 0.00167. Now we cannot add all the term in series conditions because B and C is connected in parallel connection. So you have to find out the resistance 1 divided by, and then you get 1 divided by RC equal to 1 divided by RB plus 1 divided by RC. So that value is RBC equal to 1.2 into 10 power minus 2. Then you find out the total resistance of the composite one, delta R equal to RA plus RBC plus RD plus RE. So that value, delta R is equal to 0.01717. Now heat transfer equal to Q equal to delta V divided by the overall temperature difference TA minus TB divided by thermal resistance for all levels. So delta R, that is equal to 40.7 kilowatt. From this value we can find out the interior temperature of the wall. We can find out. Suppose find the temperature at TA side which Q will be common. Thermal resistance will be very low. So Q is equal to temperature difference divided by thermal resistance. So we can find out the temperature at the interior point also. Next, after lunch, after break, we can see you have worked out these problems. Where maximum temperature will occur? This point. Heat source is based at the center of the wall. So maximum temperature will occur at the inner surface, the middle of the wall, the maximum. So the derivative of temperature at inner surface will be zero. Derivative of temperature at the middle surface will be zero. So one of the boundary condition at x is equal to zero, dou t by dou x will be zero. That is one of the boundary conditions to find the constant. Other boundary conditions are at x is equal to plus or minus t equal to surface temperature, wall temperature, TW. So using these two conditions, we can derive the temperature distribution through the wall under heat source.
What's the use of critical insulations? What is two purpose?
Insulation
means the thickness of the material. Insulation is thickness of the material at which the maximum heat transfer will occur. Maximum heat transfer will occur at this point. R naught will be critical RC, that is critical radius of insulation. Where the point is where the maximum heat transfer will occur. Y-axis represents Q, x-axis represents the radius of the insulation material, thickness of the insulation material.
So Q max, Q max is equal to R equal to RC,
critical radius of insulation, Q will be Q max.
Critical radius of insulation, next one, next.
This is typical radius of insulation. We can consider two cases. One is steam carrying steam pipe. We have to reduce the heat flow in the steam pipe using insulating materials. Second case is electrical wire cables. If resist the flow of heat, what will happen in electrical conductors? If you resist the flow of heat in electrical conductors, what will happen? Fire will take place. Fire. Because due to the overheatings. So you have to maintain some particular, you have to maintain the particular, you have to maintain the specific thickness of the insulations. The heat should be dissipated to the surroundings. If you resist the flow of heat, means what will the fire will take place. So in steel pipe, we can increase the thickness of the insulation materials. But one thing, cost will be more. So you have to find out, you have to maintain the particular thickness of the insulations. So using this some concept, you have to find out the critical radius of the insulation materials. So that is critical radius insulation is insulation with the addition of material at which the maximum heat transfer occurs. So that is Q equal to that equation. How the equation comes? Q is equal to generally temperature difference divided by thermal resistance. So thermal resistance, what is heat or thermal resistance or conduction, that is insulation materials. Another is conduction. So that is conduction resistance L R naught divided by R I divided by 2 pi KL resistance
plus conductive resistance what divided by 2 pi r naught
h. That is HA. Conductive resistance is 1 by HA. A is, that is your considered cylinder. So, that is A is 2 pi RL.
2 pi R L. L into conductive resistance H. LN R0 R 2 pi L. You have to, find out the critical radius of insulation from this equation. How to derive this equation with respect to
R is in the inner radius of this R naught is outer radius of the insulation material. So you have to differentiate this equation with respect to R naught.
R is a constant. So differentiation of this equation that means y by x by y equations. Y so the lower portions x y square x square y by x x square. So you have to differentiate these equations. Y that is denominator is whole square. Then you have to differentiate that equations. Denominator you keeping as a constant. The differentiation of t1 minus t0 is a constant. So that term will be zero. Minus t1 minus t infinity is a constant. Then differentiate again this term, differentiate this term. That term is what about this term 1 divided by 2 pi r naught is one term is there. Another term ln r divided by r1 divided by 2 pi r 2 pi kl. 2 pi kl is constant. Differentiation of ln r naught is what is the differentiation of ln r naught r1? Differentiation of ln x is ln x log x means 1 by x. So ln differentiation of ln r naught equal to 1 divided by r naught.
And you get the answer here. This term holds. Differentiation of this term is x square, then this is a constant, give me constant differentiation of L1 minus T0, differentiation of temperature is 0, minus T1 minus T infinity, this giving is constant, differentiate this term, so this term will be constant, 2 by KL is constant, differentiation of L1 R1, this is a constant, differentiation of R0 is 1 divided by R0, so that is 1 divided by R0. Minus differentiation of this differentiation of this term. What is one differentiation of 1 by x? Differentiation of 1 by x is equal to minus 1 by x square.
Minus 1 by x square.
So that is r naught square. This is differentiation of r naught square. Then heat getting equal to 0. Then t naught. We have to find out only R0. So this term will be T1 minus T0 is not equal to 0. Then this term will be equal to 0. So you eliminate the constant term. Here 2 pi L is there. Here 2 pi L is there. So cancel it. One R0 is there. Here one R0 is there. You can cancel it. So remaining term K H only. So R0 equal to K by H. So this is the critical radius of insulations. The confusion will be there for students, among the students, K by H or H by K. Many students will write in, some students will write K by H, some students will write H by K. Confusion will be there. But unit of critical radiation is meter or mm or centimeters. If you write K by H, unit of K is watt per meter Kelvin. Unit of heat transfer coefficient H is watt per meter square Kelvin, so that unit cancel. So the term M will be in the numerators. If you write H by K means 1 by M, you will get 1 by M. So that will be
suggestion, it is not correct to. So that would be wrong. So the critical radius of insulation is K by H. The example for steel pipe, R naught is always greater than RC. Is greater than RC means what? Only material waste, wastage of material will be there. But electrical conductors, you have to maintain the critical radius of insulations. Otherwise, you have to, if you resist the flow of heat, fire accident will be happened. So that is means you have to maintain the RC equal to, R naught equal to RC. But for electrical conductors or wires, that should be less than or equal to RC. The proper thickness insulation will not only provide the protection from hazards, but also to increase the dissipation of heat. This is a very important point. The differentiation is okay. You have one differentiation of this equation. Somewhat probably it will be complicated, but it will, if you understand the concept, that is temperature difference. If two materials are there, one cylindrical. Temperature means overall temperature, inner temperature minus outer temperature, divided by the resistance. One is conductive resistance, another one is conductive resistance. Both are in cylindrical shape, cylindrical. So, one by cylindrical, Ln. Ln, outer radius minus outer radius divided by inner radius, divided by 2 by KL, conductive resistance. Another one is conductive resistance. So 1 by AH, 1 by AH, A means 2 pi R naught, the radius is R is R naught, so 2 pi R naught into H. There is variable quantities, only differential quantities R naught, you have to find out R naught only. So other terms are constant. So is the Y, Y is equal to some functions, numerator and denominators, U by V forms. So denominator whole square. We can whole square, we can eliminate that term because you have any quantity to find for optimizations, you have to find, you have to differentiate that equation and equate into zero for finding optimized values. So the lower that's it, dq by dr naught will be zero. So you need not consider the lower terms. The cross multiplication, the term will be zero. So you need not D not the lawyer term whole square, we omit it. Then you write the denominator term and differentiation of T1 minus T infinity will be 0 because constant. Only variable quantity is T, R naught. So that one another thing, next minus T1 minus T infinity. Then differential quantity is this denominator term. So denominator terms 2 by KL constant. Differentiation of Ln, you have to differentiate Ln R0 only. Differentiation of R0, R1 is 0. So differentiation of Ln R0 is that log x. Differential log is 1 by x. So 1 divided by 2 pi K L R0. Plus it differentiate 1 by 2 pi R naught L H. 2 pi L H is constant. You differentiate R naught only. So 1 by X, differentiation of 1, Y is equal to 1 by X. So dy by dx is equal to minus 1 by X square. That X is equal to R naught. So 1 divided by R naught square. So that is equal to 0. Right answer is 0. So T1 minus T infinity not equal to 0. Then the remaining to 1 divided by, so the common terms 2 pi. 2 pi L is the common, so you can eliminate the 2 pi L terms. So remaining is R naught, R naught and L H. So R naught equal to K by H values. We substitute the values, unit. So you will get the R naught equal to, you can get centimeter or meters. If write in the reverse order, you will get 1 by M, 1 by meters. That will be wrong. So the R naught equal to RC. So this is a critical radius of insulations.
Q equal to T1 minus T input divided by R conduction plus R convection. But equal to T1 minus T2 divided by both are in between, we are putting for minus sign.
Minus plus plus
plus only.
Plus only. Plus only. After differentiation, it will be minus. After differentiation, it will be minus. Because the differentiation of 1 by R naught, it will be 1 by R naught square. Missing plus is not plus, that's no plus nor minus. You see, you have to write plus.
After differentiation, you have. This is the plus, plus. Here also plus term only, plus term, plus term only. Here only you can say after differentiation you can say minus plus R naught square.
This is a very important concept. They will definitely ask in competitive examination also. For the steam tire, steam pipe. R naught always greater than normal. For
IC engine, boilers, the rope is insulator. It is winding over the steam pipes. So that will be greater than R naught. So there is no problem. But electrical conductor you have to maintain, that is RC or the critical radius of insulation should be equal or should be equal. Always. Next, this problem describing this problem. Yeah, on this problem, you play ball of the internal field generations. So internal field generations. Next slide. Yes. Boundary condition at x is equal to 0, t equal to t max. At x is equal to plus or minus, here t max will be 0. Heat source is placed at center point, heat source is placed at the center point. So q is equal, at x is equal to 0, t will be maximum. So t max. So derivative of, at x is equal to 0, dt by dx is equal to 0, so boundary conditions. X is equal to 0, so dt by dx is equal to 0, or boundary conditions. And x is equal to plus or minus. In the left hand side, minus L by 2, right hand side, x is equal to plus L by 2. So what temperature is? T equal to Tw. So these are boundary conditions. So Q enters, Qx, heat flow. Q is equal to minus Ka dt by dx. And the heat conducted out at x is equal to out of the element, x is equal to x plus dx equal to Q is equal to minus K dt by dx. Then again you have to differentiate d square t by dx square into dx. So that means heat conducted out means you have to write the initial heat entering and plus you have to differentiate again these quantities. So we will get the second order equations, d square t by dx square. This is one method. Otherwise you can derive from basic method, basic heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. What is the Cartesian coordinates? Dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q by k equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou x. Here playing ball with the heat generation, so one dimensional. So y and z term will be 0, cancel. You have to consider q by k. Steady state means 1 by alpha dou t by dou term will be 0. So remaining terms is dou square t by dou x square plus q by k equal to 0. Applying the boundary condition, you have to find out the temperature and temperature distribution through this wall, and you can find out the heat flow. The temperature distribution equation through the plate volumes. Again, now how to find out the Q? Q. You have to differentiate what is the Bose's law of heat conduction. Q is equal to minus Ka to dT by dx. After finding temperature T in terms of x, you differentiate this equation and substitute that Bose's law. We will get the heat transfer equation for internal heat generation. W plus Q by 8K L square minus 4X square. This is temperature. So we are using this equation, you can find out the temperature at the interior point of the wall. Suppose you consider center point of this, this quarter point of the, suppose you consider here to find out the temperature. Point. The point temperature of this point is actually same over there. Again, minus 1 L by 4. So minus L by 4. We substitute x is equal to minus 1 by 4. We can find out the temperature at the point. Then how to find out T max? T max. To find the T max, maximum temperature. Where T max, T will be.
Substitute
x equal to 0, you will get the T max. That means sum of wall temperatures.
You have to add this wall temperature. Wall temperature starting point TW plus. Due to the internal source, some portions, you have to add these portions. That is 0, you will get the maximum temperature. Then how to find out the Q? Then Q is equal, you have to differentiate these equations. What T max? T max. T max. Q max equal to Q max. Next,